Speaking at a public rally at Ihungwa Secondary School, President Magufuli said the move will allow government officials at regional and district levels to continue with their normal functions in public service.
Sasa nataka hii kamati nayo iishe.
I want this committee to end as well. The past is past, and those who pledge but have not contributed, 4.5 billion is left, and they should bring their contributions so that we can complete our schools and hospitals. The RC should look at what has been contributed from today, sit with the disaster committee at the Prime Minister's office, who each day are in Dar es Salaam, but they should move here and oversee how these contributions are going to schools. The RC and the DC should focus on development of your region and district.
Wewe mkuu wa mkoa na mkuu wa wilaya, shughulikia maendeleo ya mkoa wako. Zunguka uhamasishe watu wa Karime.
Commenting on reconstruction of Ihungwa Secondary School, the Executive Director of Tanzania Building Agency Engineer Elius Mwakalinga said the work is being carried out with materials that will stand earthquakes.
According to specifications or assessment of the earthquake areas, we have estimated that if a magnitude 7 earthquake on the Richter scale occurs, we may be able to continue without these buildings being affected. The one that had occurred was 5.7.
But sasa hivi lililopita ilikuwa ni 5.7.
Meanwhile, the Minister of State in charge of Policy, Parliament, Labour, Youth, Employment and People with Disabilities, Janista Magama, said the government has put in place measures to avoid loss of relief funds meant for victims of Kagera earthquake, while the UK Ambassador to Tanzania, Sarah Cook, commended measures taken by the government in fighting corruption.
We want to help Tanzania achieve its vision of becoming a middle-income country by 2025. I also want to commend, Mr. President, the determination you have shown in tackling corruption. As you know, this is an issue my government has prioritised, and it was terrific that the Honourable Prime Minister attended the Anti-Corruption Summit in London last year.